guys!
What's up, kids? We are back!
It's Miss Stashi!
And Mr. Ramsey, and do not get mad at us because we're wearing the same clothes. We love Christmas that much.
I know, that's right.
We wanted to wear the same colors with the tree behind us.
Before and after.
Come on.
Get into it.
And you see, Miss Stashi got the same hair. But yeah, let's pay attention. Can you please tell me, how was your Christmas? How was your Christmas, Miss Stashi?
It was wonderful. Let's look in the mirror.
I did not get hair for Christmas.
That's okay, Miss Ramsey.
But what do you think? The kids had a great Christmas.
I believe our babies had a wonderful Christmas, especially with the last lesson, yes. Learning that the best gift was the gift of Jesus.
Wow. Yes, that was dope. I mean, I really enjoyed that last message last week, because to understand the true gift that matters, that even if you didn't get what you want for Christmas, but we got Jesus.
I know, that's right.
And that is amazing.
It is.
But this week, we got an interesting message.
I'm so excited about it. Yes.
Let's get to it.
Okay.
Oh, my goodness.
Guys, so guess what? We're going to be interviewing two guests tonight.
Uh-huh.
All right, so let's get into it.
We're going to interviewing the shepherds.
Two shepherds. So, here we go, guys.
Yeah.
Hello, 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 and welcome to Let's Talk. I'm your host, Nastashi Lewis.
And I'm your host, Ramsey Ruzon.
We have a great show planned for you today. And as you might have heard, Jesus was born in a small town called Bethlehem. Today, we'll talk to some people who saw Jesus soon after he was born with their own eyes. I'm talking to a group of shepherds who were hanging out in the fields, just chilling. These men had a very important job, keeping their sheep safe and protecting them from wild animals. They were everyday, ordinary people like you and me. Let's hear what they have to say, shall we? Guys, I'm so excited to talk to them.
I am.
So, welcome to Let's Talk.
Welcome to Let's Talk.
Oh, I think they're coming on the line. Okay. Let's see. Hold on. Hello, shepherds. Thank you for joining us.
Happy to be here.
Oh, you appear to be frozen. Oh, the frozen ribs.
Yeah.
That's okay, we can still hear you. So, let's get into your story on the evening Jesus was born.
Yes.
You were out in the fields during the night. Mm. It was just an ordinary night for you until an angel appeared.
An angel?
Mm-hmm. God's glory and light shined all around you, but I bet that was a little terrifying.
Yes, that's correct.
So, the angel appeared to you and told you, do not be afraid. I bring you good news. Mm-hmm. It will bring great joy for all the people.
Yes, that's correct.
Sensational! What else did the angel say?
Today in the town of David, a Savior has been born to you. He is the Messiah, the Lord.
Marvelous! The town of David, meaning Bethlehem? And is it true that the angel said you will find a baby wrapped in strips of cloth and lying in a manger?
Yes, that's correct.
Amazing. Amazing. According to my reports, additional angels showed up at the scene at this point. Is that correct?
Yes, that's correct.
Magnificent. I understand the angels were praising God and saying this. May glory be given to God in the highest heaven, and may peace be given to those he is pleased with on earth.
Yes, that's correct.
Outstanding. After the angels left and went into heaven, it seems that you shepherds made a decision. You know, like, well, what did you say to each other?
Let's go to Bethlehem and see this thing that has happened, which the Lord has told us about.
Indeed. That does seem like a good decision.
Oh no, wait.
What's going on?
Oh no, it seems like we dropped the call. Let's try again to connect. Oh my goodness.
Welcome back, Shepherd! what? I see you have a different background now, but it looks like you're still frozen. And that's okay. We still can hear you, though. Tell me, is that an empty manger behind you? That's a feeding trough for animals, right?
Yes, that's correct.
Stupendous! That makes sense. That makes so much sense. Since you decided to go to Bethlehem and see baby Jesus, tell me, when you got there, did you find Jesus? Just like the angels predicted you would?
Yes, that's correct.
Okay, after you met Jesus, I bet you couldn't keep quiet about everything you saw and heard. You couldn't wait to share God's message of peace with everyone. I know, I would have been all over the place.
Yes, that's correct.
Well, shepherds, I tell you what, this is an amazing story. It's incredible that you got to be a part of it. We appreciate you taking this time out for fending off wild animals to speak with us today. I know you have to get back to work, so thank you.
Thank you for having us.
Well, folks, there you have it. Quite an amazing story of the birth of Jesus from the very people who were there soon after he was born. The shepherds were amazed by what they experienced. They couldn't help but tell others about it. And as others heard what the shepherds said, they were amazed too.
They were amazed.
Meanwhile, Mary kept everything that had happened in her heart to think about it over and over and over and over and replay it in her mind. The message the angels gave that night is also a message for us today.
What's the message today?
God's peace is for everyone.
God's peace is for everyone. And God didn't go to super powerful or famous people to announce the birth of Jesus. He didn't. He sent his angels to a group of regular, ordinary shepherds, and they spread the news about Jesus to others. When we remember that God sent Jesus to be our Savior, we have peace. Wow. When we remember that, we have peace. Peace that's for every single one of us. Peace that nothing in this world could ever take away. Let's pray and thank God for sending us Jesus.
So, repeat after me, guys. Dear God.
Dear God.
Thank you.
Thank you.
For this reminder. That your peace is for everyone.
That your peace is for everyone.
You love. And care about each and every one of us.
And cared about each and every one of us.
You love us so much.
You love us so much.
That you sent your son, Jesus. To be our Savior.
To be our Savior.
Thank you. For the peace that comes. When we put our faith in you. Please help us trust you. And live your way. Every day. We love you. And we pray.
These things.
In Jesus' name. Let everyone say amen.
Amen. And don't forget the memory verse. What an awesome prayer that you can just connect that with the memory verse, because it gives us the reason why.
Yes.
You know, that no matter what, that celebrating Jesus is God's greatest gift. So don't forget, it says Luke chapter 2, verse 11. Today in the town of David, a Savior has been born to you. He is the Messiah, the Lord. Say it with me. Today in the town of David. A Savior has been born to you. He is the Messiah.
The Lord.
Now we know Christmas is all done and we're going into 2021. And we're praying that 2021, that as we just got done talking about peace, that God would have peace on earth.
I know that's right. And he definitely is. We want to go ahead and thank the shepherds for stopping by. Let's talk with us.
Hanging out with us.
They were awesome.
All the way from the manger.
All the way.
And they left all the animals behind.
Was all in the fields. They done fast forwarded to 2020.
And did you see their face when they were stuck?
Oh my goodness.
That was funny.
Guys, remember
yes.
to follow God,
love people,
and change the city. We love you so much.
Happy New Year, guys.
Thank you for staying with us for a year.
Love you guys.